Hello and welcome to Motorcycle News and the 2020 Yamaha MT-125 and 2020 Yamaha MT-03. Now both of these bikes have been updated for 2020 to bring them in line with the rest of the Yamaha MT range. Now this range comprises of the MT-125, which is your L-plate friendly version. Then you've got the MT-03, which complies with an A2 license. Then you move on to the parallel twin MT-07 middleweight. And then you're up to the MT-09 three-cylinder bike, which you can have on a full category A license. From there, we've got the full capacity, full fat Yamaha MT-10 super naked range. So, what's new for 2020? So let's start with the Yamaha MT-125. Now this bike has been heavily revised for 2020 based on the 2019 onwards Yamaha YZF-R 125. So what do you get for your money? Well, quite a lot actually. Up front we've got upside down forks which are non-adjustable, and then combined with that we've got a radially mounted single front caliper complete with ABS. In the middle, the eagle eye dimension, you will also have spotted there's a brand new frame, again from the Yamaha R125, as well as a new Euro-friendly 125cc engine, again from the R125, complete with variable valve actuation. Moving backwards from there, we've also got a fatter rear tyre. It's now gone up to a 140 section on the back, giving you a wider tyre choice and also helping with stability in the corners. So away from that, we've also got a new exhaust as well. Now, Yamaha have developed this exhaust to try and angle the sound towards the rider. Obviously, these are young riders. They want it to sound good. They want it to sound cool. They want a bike to be proud of when they're 17. And this does the job perfectly. When you're riding along, you can hear the bike really well. It makes a really nice burble, even from its standard exhaust. And then from there, there's also an optional Acroprovic unit, which just enhances that sound even more. The riding position has also been changed for this new bike. Seat height remains the same, however, the rider's now angled forward, much more over the bars, a bit like a supermoto. Up front, in front of the rider, you've also got a brand new LCD dash as well, which displays everything you might need, and in a real logical way as well. You get to see your speed, your revs, your trip. There's even a little VVA light as well, so when you hit the magic 7,400 RPM and it moves onto the high lift cams, there's a little symbol that comes up just to tell you that the system's working. The final gear ratio has also been shortened as well from the previous bike to help the bike accelerate faster from the lights, and it does this really well. There's actually more than enough performance there to get away from traffic and stay ahead of traffic at all times, despite only making 14.8 bhp as the class demands. This bike is really nice to ride, actually. We've spent a number of hours on the bike riding it through town, and we've also tackled a couple of twisty roads up in the Spanish mountains as well. And I must say, in all environments, it's really impressed me. The clutch is dead light, the brakes are really easy to use, they're not too sharp, and they've got plenty of power there. The rear brake's also really good, so you can drag it when you're moving through slow-moving traffic. In the twisties, with your big fat rear tyre, as well as really well-sprung suspension, it's a real dream. It's really good fun. Handles itself really nicely, it doesn't tie itself up in knots, and it's really impressed us. It'll be really interesting to see how it fares when we get it back to the UK. So moving on from that, and on to Yamaha's MT-03. Now the MT-03 has been a bit of an oddball in the UK. It's an A2 compliant bike, however it doesn't sell all that well, in the UK that is. So in order to try and reinvigorate sales, what Yamaha have done is they've given it a new lease of life in this 2020 version. Now, the base bike is actually the same as the original. It's still got the same 321cc parallel twin engine as the original MT-03, which came out back in 2016. That means that this current bike is also still only Euro 4 compliant. That said, up front you do get new non-adjustable upside down forks. Now these really help the bike to pop and help it to make a little bit more grown up than the previous bike. Also new is revised shock setup as well, and that shock is adjustable for preload. The shock is also adjustable for preload on the 125. Now, away from that, we've also got a brand new full LED lighting up front in this little face mask design that Yamaha have brought to both the 03 and to the 125. And then away from the LED lighting, you've also got, again, like the 125, a full LCD dash. Now, on the MT-03, it's again really easy to read. It's got everything that you would need, and it misses out on that VVA light, obviously, because this bike doesn't have VVA. Dead simple. Now, this bike goes up against some real tough competition in the A2 class, the likes of the KTM 390 Duke, Kawasaki Z400, and so on. If you're looking for excitement on an A2 license, the looks and the sort of the clattery, trail bike, motocrossy feel of that single cylinder in the KTM might be a little bit more appealing to you. That said, this bike is superb if you're looking for something as a novice rider that's not intimidating, and also as an experienced rider looking for something to cut across town and maybe do a little bit of motorway work on. The clutch is really light, the brakes are non-threatening, the seat height is really low, and it's really, really comfortable. And we've been riding it on a number of twisty roads today and in town. And in town, it really shone. It feels much smaller than a 300 at low speed, and it's really easy to use. It's got a great turning circle as well. And again, with nice narrow bars, it just makes filtering an absolute doddle. It's also really well damped as standard, and it doesn't crash over bumps, and it's really flickable. You know, it's really easy to change direction, doesn't get upset by it, and it's a real good laugh around an urban area. We also did a little bit of motorway work on the MT-03, and again, the bike was really impressive there. That parallel twin engine is real silky smooth, and there's plenty of revs there to play with. And when you're sat on the motorway, it doesn't rev too high, and there's plenty of pace to keep ahead and stay ahead of the traffic. There's also minimal vibe through the pegs and through the bars, and it's a nice place to be. The seat's also really well padded, making it nice and comfortable. Although there's no wind protection as standard, there is a small fly screen that you can get. That said, I didn't feel like I was buffeted too extremely whilst we were on the ride. So powering the MT-03 is a 321cc parallel twin engine, again Euro 4 compliant, and this is a real gem of an engine. It's not too threatening, it makes about 42 horsepower, making it perfect for the A2 license category, and there's plenty of revs to go at, meaning you can really let it scream when you get out onto an open road. The gearbox is also really slick, both up and down the box, and I didn't experience one false neutral throughout the day. The clutch is also really light, meaning you can get quick shifts done as quickly as possible. Obviously, there's no quick shifter or blipper on this model. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. If so, why not like and subscribe?